So what do we do in the case of something like this? If we were gathering in a class instead of doing this online, we might be able to just go around and count the people in the class. And let's just say we counted that there were 24 people in the class today. How many significant figures would be in that number? You're like, hey, we just learned those rules. That is two significant figures, Professor Clements. We are doing awesome. And I'd be like, well, not exactly. Remember, significant figures tell us about how we measured the number. How well did we do? Is there any chance that if I went around the room, that I would find something different in that last next digit other than a zero? Would I ever find 24.1 people in this room? And the answer is no, I'd never find 24.1 people in a room. And in fact, I'd never find 24.03 people in a room or 24.009 people in a room. Never any of that. I know that 24 is 24 because I just went around and I patted people on the head as I counted them. And in fact, that's the distinction right there, as this is what we call a counted number rather than a measured number. A measured number is where you're using like a ruler or some sort of measuring device, and you're interpreting what the measurement tells you. So if I use a ruler and I say, oh, you know, it's between the 2 and the 3, so I think it's about 2.2, that's what we call a measurement. If I got a better ruler, or I got a magnifying glass, or both, I could probably measure that instead of being 2.2, I could measure that to be 2.23. And then if I got a set of calipers instead of ruler, I could measure that to be 2.234. And then if I got something even better, no matter what I did to a measurement, I can always measure it better. But I can't count people better, right? I mean, I either count them right or I count them wrong. If I count them right, if I count that there's 24 people, I'm never going to get a better measurement than that. And those are what we call counted numbers. Now, counted numbers can be extremely large as long as they were actually counted. I could count how many pieces of paper or a ream of paper if I went through and counted them, or I could estimate that, you know, there's about 450, and that would be a measured number. Estimations are also what we call measured numbers. Okay, they're measured kind of by your brain as opposed to reality, but they are measured numbers. So if we can count something, we call it a counted number. Now, counted numbers are interesting because counted numbers, how many sig figs in a counted number? And it turns out they have infinite sig figs. No matter what digit I go past that 24, I know it's a zero because there's 24 people in here because I counted them. And so they have infinite significant figures. And the effect that has is when we're doing math with them, we ignore the significant figures of counted numbers. Now, another example of counted numbers are things that we call exact numbers. In fact, some people will use these interchangeably, counted and exact. I use them slightly different. Counted means I actually went and I could point at things and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exact numbers are usually what we call definitions. When we say there are 12 inches in a foot, we're just saying that that's just what is. It is exactly 12 inches in a foot. That's an exact number. And those have the same thing, is they have infinite numbers of significant figures, and the consequence of that is we don't include them when we're doing significant figure work in math. So addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. We put them in our calculator. Absolutely, got to put those numbers in our calculator, but we don't consider how many significant figures they have when we're trying to determine number sig figs or digits after the decimal. We just ignore those numbers. Exact and counted numbers, you ignore when you're doing significant figure work. Absolutely, you have to put them in your calculation, but you ignore when doing significant figure work. We're going to see a ton of examples of that as we go through the class, so we're not going to spend too much time on it now, but that's what I mean when I say, hey, this one's exact, and we're going to ignore it. We're going to see a lot of that going forward.